First, we will import an image in a temporary array T1. We may plot this array. You may see that JPEG image is negative. We may return to positive by subtracting from 256. Each element has three values for RGB, so we can choose one of them, the first one, and this is the first line of the image matrix. Then we shall see the dimension of this matrix and select the first element of the dimensions and store it as n. Let's try to make a compression in this primary space. For this we shall define a new matrix with 880 by 880 points initialized with zeros, and we shall copy in this the elements of T2, but only 200 of them for X and Y. So if we display now this matrix with an array plot, we'll see only a piece of the original image. Now we shall try to transform the elements of this primary space into a secondary space by using a cosine discrete transform with by bidirect form. We may see that each element of the secondary space, which is in the table T3, is a combination of all the elements in the primary space as R and S go from 1 to N each. Now there is a huge amount of calculus that has to be made for every element, and the process will be really slow. Let's see how it works. These are the first elements of the first row. We shall abort now because it is too slow, and we'll try to use a fast discrete cosine transform based on an algorithm from fast Fourier transform. Of course, the discrete cosine transform is the real part of the fast Fourier transform. So we'll use the Mathematica instruction Fourier DCT invariant 2, which means direct transform, and we may see the result from this. They are identical with those obtained before with analytic formula, and we may matrix plot these results and notice that there is a high density in the upper left corner, so we may choose only a portion of this matrix, the left upper one, as a compression technique in the secondary space. For this we copy T3 in another table, T4, but only 200 rows and 200 columns, which represent only a 20th part of the secondary space matrix. However, if we make now an inverse DCT, 3 is the inverse form, we may see the whole image with a lower quality, of course, but the whole image. We may vary, of course, the compression factor, establishing the number of the rows and columns as a square root of this factor, and then we may plot the image with this compression factor. Now we may manipulate this compression factor. We may see that for lower compression factor, the image is better, but even for high values, as 20 or 30, the image is still acceptable.